retiring next month. He has worked for the town of Danvers for 40 years, doesn't seem long to me, but there he is. He became town manager in February 1979, replacing Bob Curtis. Before that, he had been the assistant town manager, and before that, an intern. Wayne, we will very much miss you. Danvers, throughout all the years that I can remember, has been the town you always looked to for the best services in the region. Their streets were plowed first. Their rubbish was picked up faster. And in large measure, that's because of the man who's going to speak to you now, Wayne Marquis.
Thank you for those kind words. What Bill didn't tell you is that when I started the university, he was already working in sales. Gene, back at the beginning. Good morning, and I thank you for the opportunity to speak to you here today, my last such opportunity. I like the fact that we've been asked to direct our remarks to two specific issues, and simply because I think it places the spotlight on those issues as well it should. And those issues are unfunded pensions and the liability for the cost of health care for retired employees. The term OPEB, one of the most funded benefits of what that stands for, but basically is the retirement or the retirees' health insurance cost. Both the Pioneer Institute and the Mass Taxpayers Foundation have issued reports in recent years highlighting what they describe as a ticking time bomb. And I urge you to visit their websites to check out their reports. Unfortunately, in many cases, these liabilities have been addressed by pushing out funding schedules in a way which will cost taxpayers billions. And should the economy suffer a major downturn as it did in 2008-2009, could put communities in a bind where those losses have to be made up through unsustainable increases in the annual appropriations of the city and town budgets. The town of Danvers has its own Mass General Laws Chapter 32 based retirement system. A body of five, of which I'm a member. We have about 470 active employees and 395 retirees. Our asset base is $96 million, or about 59% funded. Our funding plan has our liability being paid off, same as we did in 2036. We'd like to pay it off sooner. The year 2030 would be ideal, but the impact on the town budget would be just too great. We've recently updated our mortality tables and we've reduced our projected rate of return, steps which have strengthened our system, but also added to our annual appropriation. The legislature did pass a series of retirement reforms back in 2011, which will eventually help. But unfortunately, most of those measures apply to new employees only, so it will be a long time before we really see the impact. The legislature, as has been said, has not yet adopted reforms aimed at reducing the statewide OPEB liability, a debt which in Danvers, and I think in most communities, far exceeds the liability for pensions. A reform bill had broad support in the last few sessions, but unfortunately did not have the votes to be enacted. Hopefully, OPEB reform will be a legislative priority, hopefully a priority of this chamber in the upcoming session. And Danvers will be putting money aside in the OPEB reserve account for 9 years. And today we have $3.5 million for our OPEB obligation. It's not enough, but at least it's a start. Hopefully any future savings generated by OPEB reform legislation can be applied by cities and towns against those liabilities as one possible approach to handling a very difficult problem. I was asked to speak about one item in Danvers into a stronger economy in our region. That's an easy one. It's the opening this month of the Essex North Shore Agricultural and Technical High School. All I can say is hallelujah. I've been associated with this. Thank you. I've been associated with this project for more than 15 years. And There were certainly times when it seemed like it would not happen. But we were able to assemble an extraordinary partnership of mayors and managers of selectmen and councilmen, our North Shore legislative delegation, led by the Dean of the Senate, Fred Berry, the governor, the Mass School Billing Authority, and this North Shore Chamber of Commerce. Everyone working together toward a common goal. Over $133 million in investment, 337,000 square feet of space, serving over 1,400 students, and providing state-of-the-art training in areas which will drive the engine of our North Shore economy for decades to come. And I would add that the project was fortunate to have a first-class team of contractors in Duane Construction, PMA Project Management, and the Architect Design Partnership. Last but not least, I'd like to single out School Superintendent Dan O'Connell for the job he has done in leading his staff and our project team throughout this lengthy construction process. Education continues to be a key point in Danvers. One example, a year ago we opened Danvers High School. 2 years ago, North Shore Community College opened its Health and Sciences Center. And next year, we'll celebrate the opening of the new middle school in St. John's Prep. I thank you for your time this morning and for the generous support you've provided to the town of Danvers and to myself